Dear friends, today I am explaining for you some MCQ, that is multiple choice questions for you to face the summer 2021 examination for class BSc third year, semester 6th, paper number 15, section A, physical chemistry, for the syllabus of Swami Ramananda Tirtha Marathwada University in Nanded. Now I am explaining one by one the model MCQs for the further preparations from the paper number 15, section A, physical chemistry. A device which is producing an electrical current from a chemical reaction is called an. The options are electrolytic cell, hydrolysis cell, electrochemical cell, none of the above. The answer is electrochemical cell. Electrochemical cells are the cells in which electrical energy can be created or generated. This is the option which is correct one. This is the correct option. Then the next, the electrical pressure or the driving force that sends electrons through a circuit, this driving force is called option A, EMF, option B, cell potential, option C, electromotive force, and option D, all above. All above is a correct option here. Then the third one, next one. In the complete cell diagram, the two half cells are separated by a dash dash in between. Option A, single vertical line. Option B, double vertical line. Option C, by dot. Option D, none of the above. The answer is B, that is the double vertical line. Means the in the cell diagram, whenever we are representing the two half cells, that two half cells are separated with the help of double vertical line. And hence the correct option is option B, that is the double vertical line. Then EMF, next MCQ, multiple choice question. The EMF of an unknown cell can be measured with the help of A, voltmeter, ammeter, thermometer, potentiometer. Potentiometer is an instrument which is used to find out the EMF or to measure the EMF. Hence the option D is correct. Then next MCQ. An individual electrode develops a potential with respect to the solution. This potential of single electrode in a half cell is called cell potential. Option B, double electrode potential. Option C, single electrode potential. Option D, none of the above. The correct answer is single electrode potential. Why it is so? In the question, it is clearly mentioned that an individual electrode develops a potential with respect to the solution. A single electrode, that is the half cell, which is developing the potential, that potential is called the single electrode potential. And hence the answer is C. Next MCQ, standard electromotive force may be defined as the EMF of a cell with one molar solution of reactant and products in solution measured at 25 degrees Celsius. That should be known to you. The correct answer is 25 degrees Celsius. Options are 28 degrees Celsius, 25 degrees Celsius, and C option 20 degrees Celsius, option D 24 degrees Celsius. Amongst of all these options, 25 degrees Celsius is a correct option. We are measuring the standard EMF at 1 molar solution and the 25 degrees Celsius. The next equation can be stated as option A, E is equal to E0 minus 2.303 RT upon log K NF. B is equal to E is equal to E0 plus 2.303 RT upon NF into log K. C, E0 is equal to E minus 2.303 RT upon NF into log K. D, E is equal to E0 minus 2.303 RT upon NF upon log K. Here in the option C, E0 is equal to E minus 2.303 RT upon NF into log K. See carefully the option C and option D. Option D is the E is equal to E0. Here E0 is equal to E means there is a difference between the option C and D. Option D is correct, that is E is equal to E0 minus 2.303 RT upon NF into log K. This is a correct equation with which we could find out the EMF or the potential of the cell, half cell, or the cell by using the Nernst equation. This is the Nernst equation. Nernst equation is nothing but the E is equal to E0 minus 2.303 RT upon NF into log K. This is the correct option, that is the option D is correct. Then next MCQ. In an electrochemical cell, the cathode is always a non-metal. Option B, attached to a battery. Option C, the electrode at which some species lose electrons. D, the electrode at which some species gain electrons. Cathode is an electrode in the electrochemical cell at which the electrode at which some species gain electrons, and hence the option D is correct here. Next MCQ, that is the multiple choice questions. You have to find out the, or you have to mention the appropriate choice from the answers which is given in the form of multiple choice. The site of oxygen in an electrochemical cell is, first option, the salt bridge, the cathode, the electrode, the anode. Amongst of these, where the oxidation is possible in the electrochemical cell, oxidation is possible at the anode, and hence the option D is correct here. Which statement below is not true for the reaction Fe3 plus plus electron giving Fe2 plus? Fe3 plus is being reduced. Fe3 plus could be referred to as an oxidizing agent in this reaction. The oxidation state of Fe has changed. Both Fe3 plus and Fe2 plus are called anions. The option 4 is correct here. Which statement below is not true for the reaction? Which statement is not true, that you have to find out. In this case, the D option, that is both Fe3 plus and Fe2 plus are called anions. This statement is not true. And hence the option which you have to select here is the D. Being the Fe3 plus and Fe2 plus are the cations, but instead of that, they are mentioning there that both Fe3 plus and Fe2 plus are called as anions. Means it is a not true solution. It is not a true option. Which statement below is not true for the reaction? Means in the question, we have to find out the statement which is not true. From these four options, option D is not true. Then zinc giving Zn2 plus plus 2 electrons, E0 is equal to plus 0.76 volt, Cr3 minus plus 3 electrons giving Cr, E0 is equal to minus 0.74 volt. The anode in this cell is, in these two half cells, whenever connected with each other, then which half cell or which electrode will act as anode, that you have to find out. Zinc giving Zn2 plus, Cr Zn, and D is the option Cr3 plus. Amongst of these, option C is correct, being the Zn showing the reaction, Zn giving Zn2 plus plus 2 electrons. Then here the option Zn is correct. Which of the following, next MCQ, which of the following is a half cell reaction? Half reaction. Ag plus plus electron giving Ag plus Ag, Zn plus U2 plus giving Zn2 plus plus U, it is a overall reaction. H plus OH giving H2O, Ag plus Cl giving AgCl. Amongst of these options, option A is correct, which is acting here as a half cell reaction. Then which of the following statements associated with electrochemical cell is incorrect? Means we have to find out now from option A, B, C and D, incorrect statement we have to find out, which are concerned with the electrochemical cell. A half reaction corresponds to one electrode in a voltaic cell. A cell potential, option B, a cell potential is potential difference in a voltaic cell. Option C, a Bronsted-Lowry acid-base reaction can be the basis of the net reaction in a chemical cell. Option D, the function of salt bridge in an electrochemical cell is to complete the circuit. Answer amongst of these four options is C. This is a incorrect option concerned to the electrochemical cell. Then next MCQ, write the cell diagram for the reaction. This is a reaction Cl2 in a gaseous state plus twice Ag in a solid giving twice Ag plus aqueous plus twice Cl minus aqueous. For this cell, we have to find out the appropriate or correct cell diagram or the cell representation. First, Ag is in contact with Ag plus aqueous, in contact with Cl2 gas, in contact with Cl minus aqueous, vertical line or the is in contact with the platinum. B, Ag is in contact with Ag plus aqueous, Cl minus aqueous is in contact with Cl2, in contact with the platinum. C, Ag single vertical line Ag plus aqueous, double vertical line Cl2 gas, Cl minus aqueous in contact with the platinum. D, Pt is in contact with Cl2 gas, in contact with Cl minus aqueous, double vertical line Ag plus aqueous is in contact with Ag. Amongst of these four options, option C is correct option, where the Ag giving Ag plus is shown on the left hand side. This option is correct, in which that two half cells are separated by the two double vertical line, and Ag giving Ag plus is shown on the left hand side. Means the option C is correct for the given reaction. Which metal is used for coating on steel to limit corrosion? Means to stop the corrosion or to minimize the corrosion, which metal is used for the coating? That we have to give with the help of four options. Option A, sodium. Option B, zinc. Option C, potassium. Option D, calcium. Amongst of these four options, option B is correct option, being the zinc is used as a coating material on the steel to limit or to control the corrosion. Standard cell potential is measured at. To measure the standard cell potential, we have to maintain some conditions. Measured at temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. B. Measured under the conditions of 1 atmosphere for gaseous reactants. C. Measured when ion concentration of aqueous metal reactant are 1 molar. Option D is all the above. All these are the conditions which we have to maintain for the standard potential. And hence, all the above is a correct option for this MCQ. Which of these statements about a galvanic cell are not true? Means we have to find out the statement which is not true regarding the galvanic cell. The cathode carries a positive sign. The anion migrate towards the cathode. The electrons are released through the anode. Reduction occurs at the anode. Options 1 and 3. Option A is 1 and 3, which is not true. Option B, 2 and 4. Option 3, C and 2nd and 3rd. Option D, 1st and 2nd. Amongst of these, this is the correct option for this question. These are the two statements which are not true for the galvanic cell. That is the statement 2 and statement 4. The anions migrate towards the cathode and a reduction occurs at anode. These are the statements which are not true. Standard hydrogen electrode, next MCQ. Standard hydrogen electrode, that is SHE, is selected for coupling with the unknown half cell. It consists of a platinum electrode immersed in a dash-dash solution of H plus ions at 25 degrees Celsius. Means the standard condition of the solution, or the concentration of solution, that we have to find out. Option A, 1 molar. Option B, 0.1 molar. Option C, 0.01 molar. Option D, 2 molar. Amongst of these, 1 molar is a correct answer. That is, option A is correct. Dash-dash is used as a secondary reference electrode amongst the following four options. A, zinc electrode. B, calomel electrode. C, SHE. D, copper electrodes. We have to find out the secondary reference electrodes amongst of the options which is given. Secondary reference electrode is electrode which is used to find out the potential of the cell whose potential is not known, and that is calibrated with the help of standard hydrogen electrode. Amongst of these four options, calomel electrode is used as a secondary reference electrode. That is option B is correct one. Potential measured against a calomel electrode of any electrode must be added with the value. Option A, 0.280 volt. Option B, 0.48 volt. Option C, 0.38 volt. Option D, 2.80 volt, and so on. Amongst of these four options, which option is correct one? Option 1 is correct one, That is option A is correct one. This much value we have to add. Then concentration cell is a cell in which EMF arises as a result of dash dash of the same electrolyte in the component of half cells. Does not depend on concentration. Different concentrations. C option, same concentrations. And D, none of the above. Amongst of these four options, option B is correct. Different concentrations of same electrolyte in the components half cells is used in the concentration shell. And hence the option B is correct. Branch of chemistry in which the study of flow of heat or any other form of energy into or out of a system undergoing a physical or chemical change is called. This is a question related to the flow of heat inside or outside of the system. That branch is called thermochemical, thermokinetics, thermodynamics, thermochemistry study. These are the four options. Amongst of that four options, option C is correct one. Thermodynamics is a branch of the chemistry in which flow of heat or any other form of energy into or out of a system is undergoing physical or chemical change. That branch is called thermodynamics. Answer C is correct here. Next option, the free energy function G is defined as G is equal to H minus Ts. This is the correct option. That is the equation or the mathematical definition of the free energy. Option B is correct amongst of the another options. So G is equal to H Ts minus H. B, G is equal to H minus Ts. G is equal to H plus Ts. D is equal to none of these. Amongst of these options, G is equal to H minus Ts is the correct option, being it is a mathematical definition of the free energy function G. The change in free energy is measure of option A, net change in internal energy, B, net change in entropy, C, net change in enthalpy, option D, net work done. Amongst of these, option D is correct. The change in free energy is a measure of net work done. Hence, the option D is correct here. Then we have to see the next MCQ. The work function is defined as A is equal to E minus Ts is a correct option. It is also a mathematical equation. Work function A is defined as A is equal to E minus Ts is a correct option. Option A is Ts minus E. That is not correct one. Option B, A is equal to E plus Ts. That is not correct. Option C, A is equal to E minus Ts, that is the correct option, and D is the none of these. Means amongst of the four options, option C is correct one. The change in free energy of a system is given by delta G is equal to delta A plus P delta V minus T delta S, option A. Option B, delta G is equal to delta H minus T delta S, option C. Delta G is equal to delta A plus P delta V, option D. All of these, amongst of these, all of these is a correct answer for the change in free energy system. Which out of the following is not a state function? Free energy, option A, free energy, option B, work function, option C, entropy, option D, work function. Option D, that is the work function, is not a state function. That is the correct answer, option D. The change in free energy in isothermal process for n moles of the gas is given by the equation, option A, delta G is equal to 2.303 into nRT into log of P2 upon P1, B, delta G is equal to 2.303 into RT into log of V1 upon V2, C, delta G is equal to 2.303 into RT into log of P2 upon V1, D, none of these. Amongst of these, option 1 is correct one. Option 1 is a correct option. This option is correct one. Then, next option, next MCQ. The Gibbs-Helmholtz equation is applicable to the option A, all processes, chemical or physical. Option B, all physical processes in a closed system. C, all chemical processes in a closed system. D, all processes, chemical or physical, but in a closed system. The option D is correct one, being the Gibbs-Helmholtz equation is applicable to all physical and chemical processes, but it should be into the closed system, and hence the option D is correct one. Which of the following equation is used to calculate the heat of reaction when delta G at the two different temperatures is given? Option A, Kirchhoff's equation. Option B, Clapeyron equation. Option C, Gibbs-Helmholtz equation. Option D, none of these. Amongst of these equation, option C is correct one. Gibbs-Helmholtz equation is an equation which is used to calculate the heat of reaction when delta G at two different temperatures is given. Then, next MCQ, the equation dP upon dt is equal to delta H upon T into bracket V2 minus V1 is called option A, Gibbs-Helmholtz equation. Option B, Clapeyron equation. Option C, Kirchhoff's equation. Option D, Clausius-Clapeyron equation. Option B is correct, that is, the equation is a Clapeyron equation. The Clausius-Clapeyron equation is useful to calculate boiling point or freezing point. Option A is the boiling point or freezing point. B, latent heat of vaporization. Number C, vapor pressure at one temperature if another temperature is given. And D, all of the above. Clausius-Clapeyron equation is useful to calculate all these processes or all these are the all applications of the Clausius-Clapeyron equation, and hence the all of these option is correct, that is the option D. The decrease in work function in any process at constant temperature gives the dash dash that can be obtained from the system during any change. Decrease in work function A in any process at constant temperature gives the maximum work. Option A is correct one. Option A is maximum work. Option B is minimum work. Option C is useful work. Option D is net work. Amongst of these options, maximum work is a correct option. The equation of Wendthoff's isotherm is as A, delta G is equal to 0.303 RT square into log of Kp. B, delta G is equal to 0.303 RT into log of Kp. C, minus delta G is equal to 0.303 RT square into log of Kp. And D option, minus delta G is equal to 0.303 RT into log of Kp. This is the option which is correct one, that is the option D is correct one, being it is a Wendthoff's isotherm. Option D is correct one. Next, delta H upon RT square is equal to D into ln Kp upon dt. The equation is known as A, option A, Wendthoff's isochore. Option B, Wendthoff's equation. Option C, Gibbs equation. Option D, Gibbs duhem equation. The Wendthoff isochore option is correct one. That is the option A is correct one. This is a Wendthoff isochore equation. A diamagnetic substance is dash dash in the magnetic field. Diamagnetic substances are repelled in the magnetic field, and hence the option A is correct one. Option A is repelled, option B is attracted, option C is rotated, option D is revolved. Amongst of these four options, option 1 is correct one. Option A is correct one. Why it is so? Because the diamagnetic substance shows the repelling in whenever it is kept into the magnetic field. Then the next MCQ, that is a multiple choice question. The substances which retain their magnetic field when removed from the magnetic field are called ferromagnetic substances. That is the option C is correct. Option A is given paramagnetic, option B is given diamagnetic, option C is given ferromagnetic, option D is ferrimagnetic. Amongst of these options, option C is correct one, because ferromagnetic substances are the substances which can retain their magnetic field associated with them even after removal of the magnetic field. Paramagnetism is due to the presence of unpaired electrons. That is option A is correct. Paramagnetism is due to the presence of option A, unpaired electrons, option B, option B is paired electrons, option C both paired as well as unpaired electrons, and D option is none of these. Answer is option A, that is unpaired electrons. Means paramagnetism is due to the presence of unpaired electrons. Whenever there is a presence of unpaired electrons, then that substances can show the paramagnetism. Iron, cobalt and nickel are the examples of ferromagnetic substances. Option, we have to see the options also. Option A, diamagnetic substances. Option B, ferromagnetic substances. Option C, paramagnetic substances. Option D, sometimes diamagnetic and sometimes paramagnetic substances. Answer B is correct. That is, the iron, cobalt and nickel are the examples of ferromagnetic substances. This is the option which is correct one. This is regarding the MCQs for the paper number 15, section A. Use these for study of the BSc papers of the physical chemistry. These MCQs are concerned with the chapters electrochemistry, thermodynamics and magnetochemistry. Thank you for listening to me.